Don't tell your mother. Kiss one another. Die for each other. We're cool for the summer.
So, what's up, guys? We have officially reached the end of season 12. Yeah, it's hard to believe that I've made 50 plus videos already, but yes, we are at the end of it. I think I started this, in like July or something like that, and we've just kind of gone from there. But essentially, I found a time that we have reached the point where we should end season 12 and move on to the next one. And much as always, I kind of ask my audience if there's anything I can do to improve the channel, anything that you guys want me to particularly talk about. I've always said you can always send me links over Twitter, my Facebook page. You can send it to me via YouTube, and I will actually probably be looking at some stuff in the next week or so. So, yeah, just don't, you guys can send me all kinds of, can send me any sort of advice or links or something that you just want me to talk about or cover. There's a few things that I will probably be covering as we go into season 13. But for this video, I was just going to talk about a few things. You know, nothing really special, so, you know, if you were expecting a big send-off for season 12, you might want to just click off now. I'm not really going to talk about anything too special, except maybe, you know, the fact that Marxism, communism itself, is stagnating and dying, and the fact that, and just a few things, you know, miscellaneous things that I've kind of been seeing lately. Other than that, not really going to be that much of a special thing. But I just kind of wanted to engage with you guys and, just to kind of have this be, you know, a laid-back sort of deal and not have to really go by any script or go by any sort of article or anything. So yeah, it's basically going to be just more of a did you hear that about this sort of thing. So yeah, and one of the things I wanted to just briefly cover was the fact that it does appear that Ben Carson has apparently tipped the polls in the Republican race over Donald Trump, and frankly, I couldn't care less for either person. I think Trump is a corporatocratic fascist who's, you know, out to turn America into basically a, you know, essentially what Mussolini did to Italy, with the similarities of Hitler's rise to power. Whereas Carson himself actually wants to form a police state. You know, I mentioned the whole idea of him trying to curtain off the borders and everything. And the fact that, you know, he basically wants to, you know, create this Christian theocratic sort of thing because he's a Seventh-day Adventist. And I've talked to a person that identifies as conservative who absolutely thinks that Ben Carson's a fucking idiot. So, you know, I just think that that's really interesting. And then along with much other things that have been going on, you know, a few little things have been going on in the news, California finally actually got some fucking rain. Not just got some fucking rain, it actually fucking downpoured. We actually got hail and thunderstorms and snow actually up in the Sierras for once. So, yeah, we've actually had some, and it actually poured down consistently for the better part of a day. Now, does that mean that the drought is officially over? No. We actually need much, much, much more. But from the seams of it, hopefully this is the start of the El Nino weather that they're talking about. And hopefully we can start getting some much needed water back into our reservoirs, and we just desperately need it. So it, thankfully we finally have gotten some sky water, and again, California's been just, been thirsty and craving water for such a long time, and this sort of weather is something that we need, and hopefully this is a sign that we're actually going into our wet season and can begin to see more of it. Because frankly, if we don't have this consistent weather where it's actually raining like every other day, we're screwed. So yeah, the fact that we actually get quite a lot of rain, the most rain that we've had probably in about 3 years, is quite, it's not substantial, but it's definitely quite a, it's progress. So, but until we actually see more progress, keep sending water, please. But yeah. And then, of course, the one thing I wanted to talk about was the fact that Marxism, it seems like, is stagnating and dying. And if any of you watch Jason Unruh, you probably know about that. He's been kind of cynical about this, and with justification, because if you consider the fact that, the Naxalites are, were once kicking ass in India, and now are just like severe, that have gone from like being like 20,000-25,000 strong to being like 8,000 now. It's really quite sad that they are, because it does appear the Naxalites have now actually been taking defeats, or even have not even been evolving to the point where they've become a loose band of guerrilla fighters. And it's the same if you even look at the Communist Party of the Philippines and the People's Army over there and stuff like that, especially with the American forces coming back there and the Philippines cracking down harder on these Marxist and Maoist guerrilla groups. I mean, it's getting to the point where the Communist Party of the Philippines, they actually haven't done anything really significant in a long time now, and frankly, it seems more like they've become very loose-based and, just, they're scattered throughout the country. In addition to the fact that their numbers are also diminishing, and I think have even gotten to the point where they're even, talking about actual, like negotiations and stuff like that. Now, I can't really confirm or deny anything, but they're in trouble, and this is in the third world. So that's when you really start to realize the severity of situations like this. Even the Donetsk People's Republic, what was going on in Lugansk and Donetsk in Nova Russia. The things that have been going on over there, at one point, there were communist revolutionaries. There was actually people willing to fight. But now that has become stagnated with neo-Nazi and Nazbols and even quasi-fascists and neo-fascists, frankly, that have literally taken over that movement, and people that, and essentially the communists are, I hate to say this, but the communists are getting themselves, are getting annihilated. It's important to note that this movement was a statement against the Kiev government, a neo-Nazi government. But the problem with that is that, this movement itself has allowed itself to be corrupted. And there are pro-Russian sympathizers that are within this movement, and Russian nationalists, Ukrainian nationalists, it's all gone wrong. what was once something that I supported, which was the Donetsk People's Republic, the once great dream of it becoming this breakaway socialist state, I think is gone. And anybody that actually is a socialist either is few and scattered in number, or they've turned to some form of quasi-fascism. Now, does that mean that Marxism is fascist? No, it doesn't. It doesn't even, you know, and I could go into a long debate about that, long-winded, but it's not going to be relevant to this. But essentially, Marxism is dying, folks. And I know that there's going to be a bunch of people out there screaming, yeah, well, communism was always a failure, socialism would never work anyway, blah, blah, blah. Go fuck yourself, frankly. You know, it's not about just trying to achieve it. It's standing by your convictions. It's the idea that socialism is about the idea of transitioning away from capitalism towards an equal and, you know, fair society. And frankly, a more democratic society, where the power rests in the hands of the people, the local councils, instead of a centralized government that basically, you know, a faraway government that dictates what people can and can't do. That's what it's about. That's what and revolution has always been about, getting rid of the exploitation and the unfairness of, you know, the bullcrap bureaucracy that exists within that system, and transitioning towards a system that actually, you know, that towards a system that actually can give the people what they want, you know, because the people take matters into their own hands, quite literally. But the problem is that first worldists are not going to do revolution. They're going to vote for people like Bernie Sanders. They're going to vote for, you know, some person that can give them social democracy, that can give them some sort of reform that will make everything seem all hunky-dory. But in reality, it's not really achieving anything. That's not revolution. So it really is this whole issue that, you know, first worldists aren't going to do revolution. Social democracy is basically taking over the, you know, what is essentially liberalism in neoliberalism in Europe and the Western world. And that's really not going to cut the mustard, especially as you've got this rise of neo-Nazism and neo-Nazbolism and just ultra-nationalism that's existing in places like Germany, Sweden, Greece, and France, and even Poland and Ukraine, and Russia even too. You know, it's really quite an interesting and sad and scary thought that Marxism is dying. But the reason why Marxism is basically, you know, on life support right now is because, frankly, we have not really updated our contributions. We have not, so many Marxists get stuck in this whole idea that we have to purely believe in what Marx believed, or stick to a hardline Marxist-Leninist sort of line. And see, there's nothing wrong with Marxism-Leninism, but the problem is if that is just the only thing you have to go on, it's going to become stale, stagnated, and it's going to lead to, you know, if it doesn't evolve over time, then it's going to be stuck, you know, in this historical purgatory, as you will, this historical and theoretical, philosophical purgatory of which it can't get out of. And frankly, that's what's been happening a lot in places like Russia with the Communist Party of the Russian Federation. And the reason why I use quotes there is because it I'm sorry to say this, but the Russian Communist Party has not been really truly communist in a long time. It's gotten very, it participates in bourgeois politics. I mean, it's the second largest fucking party in Russia. It's a bourgeois political party. You can't change the bourgeois system. The bourgeois system changes you. They have not been able to. If anything, they participate in a form of like democratic socialism or social democracy, but they haven't been truly socialist or actually communist at all. The Communist Party of the Russian Federation has not been a communist party for a long time. And then, of course, we can go into this whole idea about them being Stalinist as well and having this whole great, you know, almost this love affair, you know, this cult of personality with Stalin. And Stalin gave certain contributions, especially to military strategy, especially that worked wonderful in World War II. But I don't really have a whole lot of positive things I could say about Stalin, because I don't personally believe in some of the things that Stalin did, or that he wrote about, or some of his theories. So, but it almost seems that even with that, the CPRF has transitioned away from that and has basically turned into this, has started forming these quasi-fascist sort of beliefs. One of the things is that they've been staunchly anti-gay for a while, and now it's even further going to note that they'll pretty much side now with Putin's United Russia Party when it comes down to the discrimination against gay people, because they don't personally believe that gay people have the same rights as they do, and that they don't believe that gay people, basically the CPRF has, and what I find with a lot of, with some Marxists, is that they seem to be trending towards this Engelist sort of mentality. And I'm sorry, but Friedrich Engels was a notorious homophobe, and a Christian for that matter, a Christian fundamentalist for that matter. So his views when it came to Marxism were a reason why him and Marx did not always agree on a lot of things. And I'm a hardline pure Marxist. I don't really believe in a lot of Engels' theories, because a lot of Engels' theories are based in homophobia and just plain hatred. You know, Engels, let's be honest, Engels and Englists typically tend to be quasi-fascists. So the fact that a lot of these groups, especially like the CPRF, seem to be trending towards this Englist sort of form of idealism, and towards this, what I would almost even go so far to say is they're turning towards Hoxhism and towards Titoism. And those aren't revolutionary, those aren't communist, and they certainly aren't socialist. They're quasi-fascist and they're totalitarian. And then I could go on a whole spiel about the National Bolshevik Party, the NASBOLs, but I just don't feel the need to advocate that, because the NASBOLs are just, you know, a bunch of idiots just like the Liberal Democratic Party of Russia. But like I said, the CPRF has not been communist in a long time. They've been a bourgeois party, and this adoption of this Engelism, you know, social democracy sort of BS, and this reactionism that we've been seeing from them, we should have seen this coming from quite a while away, because essentially they've been corrupted by the Russian bourgeois system, and they've been corrupted by this Rush, this sense of Russian ultra-nationalism and Russian, like, superiority. I mean, I can't blame them. I mean, there is a lot for Russia to be pretty proud about. It is, right now, if above any time, is probably the best time to be proud to be Russian. But the idea that that gay people are not your equals is ridiculous. Because this is a, you know, this is something that Marxists used to believe way back in the day. Like, way back when it was getting started. Yes, there were people that actually were following English lines, but we evolved away from that because we knew better. And we adopted new theories and new ideas and stuff like that. Because why? Because communism was evolving. Marxism was evolving. It evolved to Marxism-Leninism. Marxism-Leninism was evolved into Marxist-Leninism-Maoism. I mean, even Mao had the strong emphasis on certain different things, and he actually emphasized the idea of protracted people's war. Excuse me, protracted people's war. And the idea that we have to always be constantly fighting because the bourgeois capitalist ruling class will always be trying to sabotage any sort of gains we've made. And so we always have to be constantly vigilant and make sure that they don't come back. He basically built on the exact same things that Lenin was talking about, but never got around to finishing or reflect back on and try to, contribute further to. And that's the problem, is that for a lot of people, for some Marxists and Marxist-Leninists, they reject Maoism. Some reject Stalinism, some believe in it. Some believe in Trotskyism. But the problem is, whether you believe in Stalinism, Trotskyism, or Maoism, to some degree, your Marxist viewpoints evolved somewhat. But if you just stay stagnated with the Marxist-Leninist theory of the 20s, then it's no wonder that you've started developing these quasi-fascist sort of beliefs. And why we've seen a rise in this, this sense of neo-Nazism, Nazbolism, and this rise in basically neo-fascism and quasi-fascism and ultra-nationalism and just what I would basically, I would basically call, and basically what is social democracy gone wrong? That it's really just, it's really gotten to the point where there's a reason why Marxists are considered a joke. Especially when you consider the fact that, especially when most Marxists you find are in the first world and don't want to even do revolution. They don't actually want to get out and organize and do these different things and stuff like that. Hell, I was just talking to a person that is part of the Workers' World Party. And they were talking, and they were giving me some insight into that. In fact, they actually have a message that popped up right now So, it's one of those things where I've actually considered, once again trying to join one of these parties, or at least trying to go sit in on a meeting of one of these parties. It's one of those things where I actually want to get out and help the LGBTQ community. I actually want to get out there and, do community organizing. I actually even want to be part, one of the things I'm actually considering furthering my education with is so I can go and start working for a labor union. Because I personally believe, ideologically, that would be the best suited sort of position for me to be in. Because then I can help, because these are things that even if I can't actually help bring about some sort of revolution, at least I can do something that has some sort of revolutionary, you know, sentiment to it, or some, you know, that is actually going out there and actually standing for the workers' rights, that's actually standing for the people. I mean, I'm not obviously going to, you know, I can obviously take a, you know, I could go take a gun right now and go and try to go fight the government, but I'm not going to end up winning that battle. And that's the problem, but that's the thing. We don't have revolutionary potential. Jason doesn't have it. I don't have it. People in the first world are not going to have it. So the least that we can do is at least try to make some sort of things better for our fellow proletariat. And that's one of the things that I want to do with my life, is I actually want to dedicate my life to actually serving and helping my fellow working class. Because, you know, I think that what I have contributed both here on YouTube and what I tried to, and my visions, my theories, my philosophies, I want to not only just be able to apply that here, I want to be able to apply that out there. Because what use of a Marxist am I if all I do is just sit here and bitch all the time? Sitting here bitching over a fucking computer screen, you know, wasting my time posting video after video, isn't really going to do anything except basically, you know, put it out there for like-minded individuals who also want to just bitch. And that's why it got me to thinking a while back that maybe, you know, I actually should finally put my money where my mouth is and actually start doing something that contributes in some way to the betterment of the working class. And that actually fits me ideologically. And I think these are things that I can do that would be realistic and within the confines of, you know, being able to actually do something. So, you know, I don't know. Something at least to be a little bit more positive about, considering what's going on out there. But yeah, that's just kind of what I wanted to talk about. And so that's why I wanted to, after this little depressing spiel about communism and Marxism basically stagnating, I wanted to bring up that sort of ideal. Because, you know, if we can't get revolution, if we can't get people to do revolution, then let's at least try to do something that's at least revolutionary in spirit, that's at least revolutionary in some even the smallest sense, doing something that can at least contribute to the proletariat, something that might even at times even does challenge the ruling class. It's not going to bring about revolution, it's not doing revolution, it's not revolution, but at least it's revolutionary in, you know, in the mind, at least it's revolutionary in the spirit, at least it's revolutionary in the heart. Because as long as you're still fighting for your, you know, for your ideological bounds and stuff like that, you know, the cause will never fully die. As long as you continue to hold the views and stuff like that, because there are times where even I get down and wonder if it's even worth it. But if we abandon our beliefs, then the ruling class really does win. That's why I say that I'm going to stick to being a Marxist till the day I die. In fact, there was an old quote from Fidel Castro when he said that I am a Marxist-Leninist and will be a Marxist-Leninist till the last days of my life. I intend to stay true to that. I intend to hold my beliefs to the grave, because I'm not going to turn my back on an ideology that really woke me up and has actually given me more of a broader sense of the world, given me a new perspective of thinking. So, And as long as we hold those beliefs, then communism never fully dies. Socialism never fully dies. Revolution never fully dies. That's what we need to understand. If we can't achieve it out there, let us at least preserve it in here and in here. That's something to really think about. That's at least a positive way to think, to come about thinking about this. Now, this doesn't mean that Marxism can't still turn around and still come back with a fiery vengeance. But, you know, at least for the time being, you know, we have to accept some realities and some realizations. And, you know, but at the same time, we need to stay positive. And we also need to remember that we can't just abandon the fight, even though we may be down, you know, even though we might be down by a couple touchdowns or a few runs in the bottom of the ninth or in the fourth quarter. You know, we can't abandon the game now. We have to at least stay true to it. And that's something that I think is a positive note to basically end on that particular thing. So, yeah. And, you know, like I said, there's a lot of things that I would probably love to talk about, but I would probably save them for another time. That leads me into this thing. I do want to, for the last part of this, address the haters out there and the people that I've basically been receiving over the last season particularly, but that I've always faced, but particularly this last season, the most that I've actually had, most controversial probably season that I've ever had, because I've actually spoken on a lot of issues that have really drummed up a lot of responses, whether it be from my position on the Confederate flag, whether it be my position when it comes to the men's rights movement. You know, a lot of different, or my position even on Ben Carson, you know, and Planned Parenthood. There's been a lot of, this has definitely been probably one of the most controversial seasons I've actually ever done, because I've actually had a lot of responses, both positive and negative, and even had some pretty intelligent debates with people. And so it's also been a learning experience, but definitely controversial nonetheless. So, yeah. I mean, and that's the thing, but I think at the same time, that also says a lot for what I've done this season, that this season has actually been very intriguing. It's actually been very engaging. It's actually probably been one of my most successful seasons, and probably one of my best seasons to date, because I've been putting out some of my better content this season, now that I've actually not been distracted by other, you know, influences and stuff like that, and I've actually had a chance to focus my energy into the actual things that matter. And so the responses that I've ended up getting, whether they be people that are just, you know, blah, 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 so mad, or, you know, actually even agreeing with me, because I've actually had a lot of people even this season, probably more than any other season, both who have said that, oh, you're just full of shit and blah, 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 or, oh, I could see that reasoning, but I disagree with you on that one, you know, yada, yada. It's like, you really need to focus on this, or you're completely missing the point on this, you need a lesson on this, or, you know what, Nick, I actually really did like what you posted, in fact, it's like, keep up the good work, blah, blah, blah. I've had all these different responses this season. My subscriber count, I think, literally went from, I think I started this year with probably a one, I think, because at one time, I will be honest with you, at one time, I had maybe 38 subscribers. And within like the last year and a half, that number has increased by almost 100. This year alone, I was probably, by I think at the beginning of this year alone, if not a little further after that, the fact that a little further after I had came back from the East Coast, I think I had about 108 subscribers. That number now is 134. So not only is my view count, not only is my does it seem like my channel is getting better, that the content is getting better. This, because of this, my subscriber count is increasing. My views, I've been noticing, have been increasing. And I'm absolutely just humbled by that. I'm really proud of that. Because I'm now getting this increase of traffic to my channel. Now, granted, there are also third parties out there that are, you know, have my videos out there. You could literally, you know, YouTube search my channel and it will come up. But, yeah, like I said, I'm very proud of that. I mean, it's a humbling feeling at the same time, because I've done all this through my own hard work. Nobody else works on this with me. I do this solely on my own. I film my videos, I edit my videos, I upload my videos all on my own. I don't pay anybody to do this. This is my own content. This is my own work, my own hardworking efforts to do this. And I spend probably, I mean, I could film a video for right now, it's been almost 37 minutes. But then the editing process takes sometimes anywhere between half an hour to sometimes even, I've had some videos take longer, as long as up to 2 hours to fucking edit. Actually, even longer than that. I don't even know what the longest time is. And then, if that's not one thing, then you have to wait for that to all process. And then I have to upload it to YouTube, which sometimes takes several hours at a time. So you're talking, for one video alone, can take several hours just to get it all published. And then I have to publish it to YouTube and to my social networks. So I go about a lot of that. And I do none of it, and I do all this for nothing. You guys are watching this completely free, and I intend to continue to, you know, to make this completely accessible and free to the best of my ability. Because you guys are subscribers to my channel. You guys are subscribers to my show. And unlike Netflix and Hulu and Amazon and all these other bullshit fucking sites, I don't charge you a thing. It doesn't cost you a thing. Except maybe your monthly setup fee, but it really does, for your own internet. But other than that, it really doesn't. It doesn't cost you guys a thing, and that's really special. Because I don't intend on profiting off you guys, because that, one, that would go against my ideological views, and two, I think that personally we are all family or friends or something like that to some extent, and that we have some sort of, that obviously we have some sort of connection, because you guys clicked on the, decided to, out of curiosity, click on this channel or click on this video. And the fact that we've been able to make it this far in what has been 4 years that I've been doing politics, and probably the 5 years that I've actually been doing actual videos, and the 6 years that I've been on YouTube. I mean, we've come a long way in just that short amount of time. And the fact that the view count and the subscriber count is going up is amazing. The people that come to my Tumblrs, still amazing, or even my Twitter, my Twitter followers. I'm getting people that, I don't use it that often, but I got Twitter followers following me, and I'm getting people hitting me up on the Facebook pages. And it's all very humbling to me. It really is. It makes me proud, but it makes me very humble at the same time, because again, I do this all for nothing. I own my own means of production. This is what I do right here. What you see is what you get. And I intend to keep making the best content I can for my viewers and for, you know, and for everything else. So I thank you guys so much for that. You guys absolutely rock. And some of you have been here since the very first fucking day that I uploaded, started uploading real politically charged revolutionary sort of videos, you know. And way back when I was a fucking bourgeois liberal punk that supported the Occupy Wall Street movement. Oh my god, I look back on those things and I cringe sometimes at how idiotic I looked. And how idiotic some of my, views sounded. But, you know, that was back, my views evolved, and I'm still evolving to this day, and I'm probably going to look back in 4 years at probably what I did here and think, I was a little off on that one. So, my views are always evolving, and I think as human beings, and as I said, that's the thing when it comes down to politics, especially ideologically sounded, we have to always be evolving. Because if we don't evolve our views, it stagnates, it gets stale, it's all part of the learning process, and we've always got to keep that momentum going. Otherwise, we run the risk of falling to reactionism, or we fall victim to basically, questioning our own judgment and stuff like that. So it's really nice, and I really thank you guys so much. I thank people like Jay McGowan, who's been a follower on here for quite a while. He and I actually, he and I both watch Jason Unruh. And, again, thanks to Jason Unruh and people like Scottish Socialist and to John Doe and all these other... And to Proletarian TV and all these other different groups that inspire me and stuff like that, that I've done videos and stuff like that, and even still want to do videos that are inspired by these people. And thank you to people out there that do continue to follow me. There's just so many people out there, I can't even, think of a person that I actually want to start with. But, yeah, I'm just going to say it, to every single subscriber on my list, to everyone who's ever watched my videos, thank you very much. To everybody who's even commented, both the haters and the supporters, thank you. To the haters, I want to address you now. Thank you, because you are my biggest fan group. Also understand, I really don't give a fuck what you think about me or the things that I say. Because, like I said in a previous video, I really don't give a fuck anymore. I used to really give a fuck what people say, but I really don't anymore, and I'm not going to. People don't like the fact that I do things about, that criticize the men's rights movement and its reactionism. You know what? Guess what? I'm going to do more. I'm going to find more shit and do about it. I'm probably might start doing something like I did with Westboro Baptist Church and the KKK groups. I might end up actually starting, this sort of thing where I just poke fun at it all the time. Or every once in a while. I might make that a new segment. You don't know. You don't know. You don't have any control over it, so... You know what? You don't like me? Buzz off. I don't care. You don't... To the people that don't like me because I criticize Anita Sarkeesian, guess what? I'll criticize her a little bit more. You don't like that I... You don't like the fact that I... that I'm always talking about Marxism and stuff like that, guess what? I'm going to come up with more political theories and stuff like that. And by the way, at some point, yes, I am going to come back and start finishing those political theories and ideology things that I started. A while back, I had done that one about the liberalism of, you know, and broke that down, and I'm still working on the communism-socialism thing. That will eventually go on, then I'll, and then anarchy, and then conservatism, fascism, nationalism, all this sort of stuff. I'm gonna at some point be talking about that. So I will be doing the political breakdown videos again, because I did the one on liberalism, was gonna do the one on communism, but then I kinda got stagnated over the last couple years. So at some point I will be finishing those up, because I want to do that, put that all in a set at some point, political breakdown and stuff like that. Also, there's a video that I was doing about a blog that I was going to be doing about the comparisons of religion to political ideologies, political theories. I will be finishing that up at some point in the future, and we'll do a video on that. So that will also get published. And a while back I talked about a book that I wanted to do at some point. At some point, I probably will get around to doing it. I just don't know when that's going to be. I was at some point going to put out that boxed set, but I think I'm going to end up scratching that for the most part. I mean, because it doesn't really... It seems awful redundant now, because you guys can pretty much just click on, now on the tabs for the seasons and just watch each season through. So it... To make a box set just kind of seemed awful redundant now. But yeah, there's a lot of different things that that I want to do and that I hope to get done. And so, like I said, I absolutely love you guys, and I want to thank every one of you for being here. And again, to the haters, you know, hey, you don't like that I do things about, you know, that I talk about a certain thing or a certain, you know, or, you know, this, that, and the other thing, and guess what? I'm going to do more of it. Every time you criticize me about something that I've talked about or that I've done, it really only motivates me to want to do more of it. And for some reason, I think that seems to work, because the more that I do on these things, the more traffic I seem to get. So... really, your critique of me doing certain things, such as the things on the men's rights movement, my, you know, my issues with Ben Carson, and other shit that I've talked about this season, apparently that's just haters speech, roughly translated to you should do more of that. And apparently it seems to work, because people seem to continue to like me, and this has seemed to be one of my best seasons so far. So, you know what? Yeah. Deal with it. And also, by the time this is uploaded, I have a couple other videos that I had been trying to get to. That's why I've been having this marathon running all week, of videos that I've just been just projectile vomiting at you guys, and because I was trying to get caught back up and stuff like that. So by the time I put this on here, those videos should be up, and and that way we've got the full on thing of videos that I had for this season, because that's another thing I really want to try to actually keep on top of my video production and not leave old videos and stuff like that behind. So, because I take the time to film them, I should be able to upload them. And, the fact that I've even... I mean, don't get me wrong, there are some videos that I look back on and just think, shit, I should have probably put more thought and energy into that. Or maybe I should delete that, but you know what, whatever. But no, I will be continuing to do my best in providing the best content I can for my viewers. So, yeah. I mean, again, I could go back through the list of things that people fucking don't like about me, and I really don't care. I mean, yeah. I wanted to say one more thing, because... yeah. Oh yeah, my issue, when it came down to issues such as, like, social construct theory and different things that I've talked about, people don't like it that I talk about police brutality and think that, you know, all I'm trying to do is make up these insidious lies about the police, you know, police apologists. And so people don't like that I'm a police, you know, that I, you know, have a bone to pick with police apologists, and that I continuously critique police apologists and this thing about where everybody just tries to, sugarcoat everything and justify what the police brutality that occurs in this country. People don't like me talking about police brutality. Guess what? I'm going to continue doing it. I'm not going to stop. Who's going to stop me? You? Who cares about you? I'm not going to stop. You know, people got pissed at me because I did the thing about veganism, because I was going after vegan gains and freely and stuff like that, and talking about fascist veganism. Guess what? I might do more about those. I might do more videos on those. Again, who's going to stop me? You? What? It's like, what are you going to do? Hit me with a twig? You're not going to do anything. You can't stop me. This is my channel. And I think, ultimately, what also has really driven my view count and the comments that I've gotten and the subscriber count and the fact that more people are watching my videos and giving me, you know, more positivity and stuff like that, and negativity, frankly, too, because with every new reaction, there's an opposite reaction. But yeah, because I think I've been getting more responses this year was because it is my better content that I've been putting out. And the fact that some of the people that are actually responding positively to this, my video content, is probably because I have finally taken that solemn oath that I'm not going to give a fuck anymore what people think. Because that's what's usually held me back before, was the fact that I was always trying to please other motherfuckers, and I was always trying to somehow, you know, basically whoring myself. I still do, but, you know, whoring myself to basically just try to, you know, it's like, please like me, please like me. And now, I really don't care whether people like me or not. I like that people like me, but I also like that people don't like me. You know, because I really don't care either way. And I'm not going to change what I'm doing just because. Just because someone doesn't like a certain thing that I said. Well, fuck you. I don't care. Go away. I'm not forcing you to click on the video. So that's the thing. I basically have said, I'm not going to give a fuck. You know, I'm not going to let anybody push me around anymore and stuff like that. Don't get me wrong. I'm going to take suggestions. I'll take people's suggestions. You know, like I said, anybody who wants to, anybody that basically wants to throw out an idea or something to make the channel better or something, a topic that they want discussed, you know, bring it on. I can take some criticism. I can take some, you know, and I can take suggestions. And do people that basically just hate on me all the damn time and basically think that, you know, I'm just full of shit and should get off YouTube and blah, 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 or, you know, that they don't like a certain thing that I did, it just translates to me that, maybe I should focus more on, do more of that then. And guess what? I do. I have. I will. Because, you know why? because it gets responses, and people seem to actually just love it. And as I said, I've actually, and as you've noticed, I've changed some formatting too of the, to what I've done over, you know, probably over the last year. Every so often I will post personal videos, and in fact I will actually start, I haven't done it in a, probably a, since my I had got this new laptop, but I will actually start filming the intimate videos, the cell phone videos again. I'll probably start posting those again too. In fact, I kind of wanted to do that. There was a video I was going to do about the room tour, but my phone kept dying and didn't have the space at the time. But I will probably do a room tour video, put that up, and I'll probably, you know, there, so I will actually start bringing back those more, the intimate videos and stuff like that, some of those things. I would say that I would bring back NorCalNick commentary, but I think that pretty much what I do now is pretty, it's all part of Corner anyway, so it what you see is what you get anyway. I think the closest we get to commentary is probably those intimate videos that, you know, I do, those personal videos that I do. I'll be doing more of those. I'll probably be bringing those back. I might even, if I get more traffic, I might even kind of take a book out of Jason's channel, which is to do mailbags or something like that, and just start in which people criticize me and blah blah blah, and just go after that. I will be and like I said, I will be probably doing some of those more goofy videos, like the thing when I did the beer float last year, and these different little goofy little things every once in a while. I'll probably do some of those too, because every once in a while I do want to get away from the mundane talk of politics and current events, and I do like to focus on, you know, some goofy shit every once in a while, because that's also seemed to be well received, and plus people actually gets to see, you know, what, how much of a real goofball I can actually be. So I will try to start doing some of those too, and come up with ideas to, you know, make that, make myself a little bit more personable, instead of this grumpy asshole that sits in front of you all the time. So again, thank you guys so much for another great season, for all the great responses I've gotten, for making this probably one of the best seasons I've ever done. I mean, you guys have been with me through thick and thin, whether you've been here since day one or you just joined, experience is all the same. For those of you that have just joined, keep coming back, because this is really, you know, we've got a lot of really awesome people that, you know, that have been here for a while, and, you know, I meet so many new people doing this. So I want to thank every single one of you. Thank you. Thank you. I love you guys. And I will see you probably in another week or in about a week or two. You know. So until next time, until I see you on the other side in season 13, I'm NorCalNick, leader of the revolutionist movement. This has been NorCal Corner. And this has been season 12. Later. Peace.